All right, folks, my name's Jonathan. For the people who don't know me out there, I'm known as the DJ Tutor. Now then, this is my interpretation of the structure of dance music. I found a way in which I can actually break it down and show everyone out there how dance music is all fitted together. Now then, I've made over 700 videos on YouTube, and not once have I ever asked anyone to rate videos. I would like you to rate this video according to how well you think I have explained the structure of dance music. There are stars. You can either give me 1 if you think it's crap, or 2 if you think it's not bad, up to 5, it's entirely up to you. If you don't want to, no problem. Right, I'm going to stop the camera and I'm going to show you my interpretation. Hold tight. Alright folks, here we go. This is the structure of dance music by Jonathan, the DJ Tutor. Right, okay. Now then, what is dance music? How do we structure it? Okay, a real bar in music is 1, 2, 3, 4. So you continue doing that. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Now then, what I'd like to do, I'd like to just make that a little bit bigger and longer. How we're going to count it is this. 1, 1, 2, 3. 2, 1, 2, 3. 3, 1, 2, 3. 4, 1, 2, 3. But we're going to count it actually in time. 1, 1, 2, 3, 2, 1, 2, 3, 3, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3. All right, now then, let's say we class that as a bar. Now then, all right, what are bars? If you imagine a prison, would you have bars like that all over the place? Well, I doubt it very much. Or would you have them, now bearing in mind, you know, I haven't used any rules or anything like that, would you have them equal spaced? Probably yes. In fact, you definitely would. Now, that in essence is the way you should treat bars. They are equally spaced in dance music, and they're in time, and logically they're in beat. Now, a record, a tune, whatever you want to call it in dance music, it's got a start and a finish, and it's got a middle bit. Right. Now, what I want you to consider is this, okay? If we took that timing as a block, 1, 1, 2, 3, 2, 1, 2, 3, 3, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3. All right? Now, and then what we do, if you imagine tiny segments in there, like a prison, like the bars, and then what we do, we look at this one step further, one step closer. Now then, what I want you to bear in mind here, I'm going to start writing things down here as well. Where's my pen gone? There it is. Right. I want you to class B as the beat. BL as the bass line, M as the melody, V as the vocals, and I forgot one here, didn't I? I equals instrumental, break. Okay, right, now then, what is a tune? How does it start? How do a lot of, when I say modern day dance music, but you know, house, that sort of music, how does it start? It normally starts just with a beat. But if you class, like I put over here, if you class these bars, that big square, and all of a sudden that square is reduced to this tiny segment here, that is a bar. And in that, we're counting 1, 1, 2, 3, 2, 1, 2, 3, 3, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3. And we're doing that 1, 2, 3, 4 times. So at that point, we've got the B, which is just the beat. Now, after those 4 times, we're going to have another section here. We're going to have B, which is the beat, plus we're going to have the B and the L, which is the beat and the bass line. And then we're going to go to another section. Here, we're going to have the B, which is the beat, plus the BL, which is the bass line, plus we could have M, which is melody. And then at this point, we could have all of those. And if I put a cross there and a circle, you'll know that all of those is that. Plus, we can have V, which is the vocals. And then at this point here, we could just have all of that and not the vocals. And then at this point here, we could have the I, the instrumental break. At this point here, we could have all of those, which was here, which was the beat and the bass line and the melody. And let's say we could have V again, the vocals. At this point here, we could just have the B. At this point here, we could have maybe I again, instrumental break. At this point here, we could have B, and maybe we could have M, just the beat and the melody. At this point, maybe instrumental break. Maybe this point here, we could have all of those from this point here, and then back down here, we're finishing off with just beat. Now then, this isn't a certain record. This is in no way any record. This is just an interpretation of the structure of dance music. Consider this. Now, I've always said when people mix, what they tend to do, not most of the time, but when you start to mix, it's a good idea to just mix in from this point and this point. But a good DJ can interpret any individual section along a different tune, and he can find different sections in other tunes and put them together. So for example, here, I, instrumental break, in the middle of this particular record, he can possibly bring B, the beat of a second tune, and incorporate it at this point here. And he knows that the bass line of the second tune, when that starts, will work with all of this from the first tune. And he knows that the rest of the second tune will work along here. If it doesn't work at any point, he knows he can cut that off straight away there, or cut it off there, or cut it off there. This really is the way I look at dance music, how it's structured. I don't think I've got anything else there, but I hope you get the sort of general idea. This really is the structure, the way dance music is put together. And it's all about these small, tiny segments. Now, I want you now to get any dance music, any particular house record you've got, or soul record, R&B, hip-hop, jazz, reggae, funk, techno, trance, and just count. 1-1-2-3, 2-1-2-3, 3-1-2-3, 4-1-2-3, 1-1-2-3, 2-1-2-3, 3-1-2-3, 4-1-2-3, 1-1-2-3, and so on. And I want you, every time you get a little block, I want you to put a mark. And then another mark. But when you hear a change, then go to another separate line and another mark. And another mark. So here you could have two marks and just the beat. Here you could have beat plus bass line. And see what you think. Let's see if you can find a structure in the music you've got. Thanks for watching. It's my interpretation, and I hope somewhere down the line this will help someone. Thank you for watching. Practice and enjoy.